Welcome to the Christmas Eve service at Victoria Congregational Church, where no matter who you are or where you are in life's journey, you're welcome here. This evening service will be the ABCs of Christmas. This service is written by Aaron Klassen, Minister of Spiritual Formation and Congregational Development at Deer Park United Church of Christ in Calgary, Alberta. And the information will be on YouTube here, if you'd like to connect to the website. So this is Christmas Eve, and I ask you to get a candle ready as we get into the time later in the service after we light the Christ candle. And there'll be a time that we light a candle and sing together, Silent Night, Holy Night. So at this time, follow me, and we'll go to the communion table. And we also, in this time of service, have a candlelight communion service. So at home, you can join in at this time. Here's just a regular bread plate, a dessert plate, just a loaf of bread, a cup. I have Welch's grape juice here, whatever juice you have available, or water. Just pour some into the cup. And when it's time, you'll have the bread to break, and the wine to drink, or the juice to drink. So now let us join together as we worship and as we welcome the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
worship tonight is taken after Psalm 96 and Luke chapter 2. Join me in this responsive call to worship. Sing to our God a new song. Sing to our God, all the earth. The heavens are telling the glory of God. Let earth rejoice, let trees of the forest sing for joy. Amen. Let us join together as we sing, O come, all you faithful. Scriptures seep into our hearts to be treasured and pondered anew. We are here. We are ready, O God. Let the light of your love break forth. Amen. As we light these Advent candles tonight, they help us to recall our journey to this point in time at the end of Advent with gifts of Jesus Christ to us. Hope, peace, joy, and love. Christmas. Come in, sit down, we're glad you're here. We want to share a story with you. It's a story you might know well, one you may have heard before. Tonight, we want to tell you this story with something else we know well, our alphabet. A is for angel. The angel Gabriel began the story by telling Mary, "Good morning. You're beautiful with God's beauty, beautiful inside and out. God be with you. Mary, you have nothing to fear. God has a surprise for you. You will become pregnant and give birth to a son and call his name Jesus." B is for Bethlehem, where our story takes place. People traveled from far and wide to get to Bethlehem, which was not a very big village. C is for census, which means an official counting of all the people, the reason so many people came to Bethlehem. D is for donkey. A donkey carried the family on their long journey. Mary and Joseph had to travel 107 miles along the Jordan River to get from Nazareth to Bethlehem. That's a pretty long journey. E is for exhausted. That's how everyone must have felt when they arrived. It would take about 36 hours of walking to go that far. That's 3 days in a row of doing nothing but walking. Would bless the whole world. While they were there, the time came for Mary to give birth. She gave birth to a son, her firstborn. She wrapped him in a blanket and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for him in the hostel. G is for the good news about to be shared with all the earth. This is what the angel said. There were shepherds camping in the neighborhood. They had set night watches over their sheep. Suddenly, God's angel stood among them, and God's glory blazed around them. The shepherds were terrified. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. I'm here to announce a great and joyful event that is meant for everybody worldwide. A Savior has just been born in David's town, a Savior who is Messiah and Master. This is what you are to look for, a baby wrapped in a blanket, lying in a manger." At once, the angel was joined by a huge angelic choir singing God's praises. "Glory to God in the heavenly heights. Peace to all men and women on earth." We can imagine a world where God's peace reigns, where there is no war or hunger. And if we can imagine it, we can do it with God's help. J is for joy. Joy is a kind of happiness that comes from God. It cannot be dampened and is always shared. The birth of Jesus gives us joy. Most kings were born in palaces, surrounded by servants. He was born in a stable, surrounded by dirty, smelly shepherds. Most kings rule with power and fear. Jesus rules with mercy and love. L is for lost. When Jesus grew up, he told a lot of stories, and three of them were about lost things that were found. He loved to find lost things, and when you are with Jesus, you will never be lost. He is the good shepherd who does anything to find his lost sheep. L is also for love. Jesus summarized his ministry by saying, "Love God and love your neighbor as yourself." M is for manger. A manger is usually used to hold food for animals, but this time it held the baby because he had no crib.
Thank you.
is for Noel. Noel is another word for Christmas. It means new birth, and that's what happened in our story. That's what happens every year at Christmas time. That's what happens every time we decide to follow Jesus. He is born anew in us. O is for offering. The wise ones gave gifts to the baby, and we can offer our gifts every day. We give our time, our talents, and our treasure to God, and pray that as a church, we are good stewards of all that is entrusted to us. So we share our gifts now. Christ comes, our hearts are full, our joy is boundless. May this offering be a living message of peace, love, spirit, joy, and hope to this church, to this community, to this nation and world. Amen. P is for peace. Jesus is the Prince of Peace, and is the source of the kind of peace that surpasses all understanding. Q is for quiet. When we begin a time of prayer and quiet, allowing God to speak to us, and joyfully when the quiet is broken by small voices. R is for revealed. Revealed means showing us something that was once hidden. God revealed to us what love looks like by giving us Jesus. Jesus is love and reveals to us the way to love one another. S is for star. One special star guided wise ones to come to see the baby. They were mysterious and they lived far away, but they brought gifts to Jesus because they knew what he would grow up to be a king. Matthew chapter 2 states this, instructed by the king, they set off. Then the star appeared again, the same star they had seen in the eastern skies. It led them on until it hovered over the place of the child. They could hardly contain themselves. They were in the right place. They had arrived at the right time. They entered the house and saw the child in the arms of Mary, his mother. Overcome, they kneeled and worshipped him. Then they opened their luggage and presented gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. tea is for table. When Jesus grew up, he invited all to his table. He gave his friends bread and wine and told them to remember him always. When we gather at the Lord's table today, we call it communion because we come together. So at this table, we also remember the next letter. U is for unity. Communion is a time when all people can come together and be one. Just as many grains come together to form one bread, we who are many people come together to be one body of Christ. As we celebrate the birth of our Savior. Amen. Let us pray together the prayer our Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. The bread which we break the cup of thanksgiving for which we give thanks. Let us partake of the gifts of God to us through Jesus Christ. The body of Christ given for us. The cup of blessing given for us. Let us pray together the prayer of thanksgiving. We give you thanks, O God, that you have come to us through Jesus Christ, both in the midst of time and history, in the city of Bethlehem, and in the timeless presence of Christ's Spirit, as we receive the gifts of bread and wine. Send us out into the world rejoicing, ready to share your love with people we meet, through the grace of Jesus Christ. Amen. V is for vulnerable. Vulnerable means able to be hurt. Every baby is very vulnerable. And so we are when we love one another. God became vulnerable when Jesus was born, and we are called to be vulnerable when we love our brothers and sisters. W is for wonder. Like the wise ones, we stand in awe and wonder of the newborn king. X is for Christ. X is the Greek letter chi, the first letter in the word Christ. The X is one of the most ancient symbols of Christianity. People have been using the letter X to stand for Christ for centuries. And now we light the Christ candle, symbolizing the coming of light into the world. Jesus is born. We have lit the four candles representing the 4 weeks of Advent as we awaited the blessed hope of our Savior, Jesus Christ. These candles symbolizing gifts of Jesus Christ to us, hope, peace, joy, and love. Today we light the Christ candle, the candle of hope made real in the Son of God come to earth at Christmas. In Christ, the grace of God has appeared, bringing the good news of salvation for all. Holy One, we give you thanks for your presence among us in Jesus, your child, born into a poor family. Christ has entered our lives and embraced our hope and our struggle, showing forth the power of your love in healing, teaching, and challenging the powers of the world that lead to death. With confidence in your faithfulness, we welcome your beloved child in our midst. God be with us in the light of Christ. Y is for you. You angels, you wise ones, you shepherds, you sons and daughters, you mothers and fathers, you friends and strangers, you're all here to worship and celebrate the birth of Jesus. Z is for zeal. Let your zeal for Christ burn brightly as you light your candle. Know that the light of God burns much, much brighter. Though the candle light will die out, the light of God is steadfast and endures forever. As the lights are dimmed, let us light our candles. One candle is but a flicker, but together we create a bright flame of Christ's light in the world. Consider the beauty of our light shining together. Jesus is the light of the world. Jesus is the hope of our tomorrows. May we be witnesses of the light that Christ brings. Amen. Let us light our candles as we begin to sing Silent Night. Christmas Eve and Christmas Day and all your days are blessed with the Christ child. Now let us receive the benediction, which is based upon Isaiah chapter 9. A child is born to us, a son is given. His name is Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Prince of Peace. Christ is born. Merry Christmas to all. Christ is born. Merry Christmas to all.